is here, even though it doesn't really feel like it out there. But that means tick season is upon us. Those pesky, bloodthirsty parasites can transmit diseases, including Lyme disease. Dr. Apple Bodmer with UW Health joins us now. And it seems like we talk about Lyme disease every single year, but it is really a serious disease that we need to pay attention to.
Yeah, Lyme is an illness that's caused by Borrelia burgdorferi, which is a bacteria that lives inside the deer tick. And this gets transmitted to humans and to other animals when the tick attaches for a blood meal. It generally takes about 36 to 48 hours for transmission to occur. So it's not something that happens immediately after mm-hmm. the tick bite, but we want to make sure we get those ticks off so we don't develop Lyme. The initial symptoms can include fever, headache, fatigue, and rash. The rash typically will show up in the first couple of days mm-hmm. or weeks after the tick bite. And this is a time period when the blood tests tend to be negative. So it's important to recognize the rash so that we can diagnose and treat Lyme early. If we leave it untreated, some of the symptoms of late Lyme can involve damage to the heart, to the nerves, and to the joints. So it can be significant.
Very serious stuff we're talking about here. So what does that rash even look like then? What should we be looking for?
So it can take some different forms, but the most characteristic is called erythema chronicum migrans. And this starts off as a red patch or plaque right at the mm-hmm. site of the tick bite. And then it expands over time to develop the more typical target appearance. It'll have a dark red or purple center. You will have some clearing around the edge, so it might be pink or a little bit lighter red or even normal skin mm-hmm. color, and then a darker rim around that.
So is it kind of true that bullseye pattern yes. is what we're looking for then?
Exactly.
I know I've heard that before.
Yeah, yeah.
Perfect. So where and how are we picking up these ticks? What do we need to be thinking about when we're out and about?
So ticks are active between the months of April and October. Mm-hmm. So it's a really long season.
Yeah.
It isn't just the middle of the summer. They live in wooded areas and areas with tall grass. So if you're going to be in any of these tick-friendly places, you want to make sure your skin is as covered as it can be and that you use an appropriate tick repellent. They can also come into the home on family pets that might be roaming outdoors. Mm. So it's really important to treat your pets prophylactically and to monitor them for ticks as well. Dogs and cats can develop Lyme disease as well, so it's something we need to think about for our pets as well.
All right, so what do these little insects look like here, these nasty ticks?
Yeah, they're little tiny round to oval shaped, and they have six little legs that kind of stick off of them. The deer tick is the one that's responsible for Lyme disease, and ticks on their back, they'll have this hard area right below their head, and that's called a scutum. The deer ticks typically have a solid colored scutum, whereas some of the other ticks, like the Lone Star tick or the brown dog tick, which mm-hmm. we see a lot around these mm-hmm. areas, they have patterns to their scutum, including usually some white or lighter tans. When ticks are engorged, they just look like these nasty gray mm-hmm. balloon-filled bags. They're kind of gross. But the scutum doesn't change with engorgement. So when they're engorged, they all kind of look the same, but the scutum will stay the typical pattern that it has. So that's the way we can identify them.
All right, so what about removing them? What should we do that? I mean, do you go to the doctor?
Yeah,
what should you do?
I'm planning on talking about that really in detail next time.
Fantastic.
And giving some examples about different devices we can use to remove them appropriately.
All right, fantastic. Dr. Bodmer, thanks so much for being with us. Stay with us. We're going to send things over to AJ, who has a full look at your forecast.